Alrighty, today we're going to be taking a look at a very unique, interesting problem that's happening with this pressure tank and pressure switch. If you like this kind of content, please make sure that you like and subscribe. I will be posting daily with all sorts of interesting little things that you may come across in the world of well and septic. So, today we have a system that was built in October of 2023 with a pressure switch that looks pretty clean. All this dust is just drywall dust. This house has recently been renovated. Now, how this system works, you have your water supply line over here that comes down through the T and into the pressure tank. The top part of the tank is going to be air, bottom part of the tank is going to be water, and there's a little bladder in between. And what will happen is when the air pressure in the system drops, so for this particular circumstance, it's a 30-50 switch. When the pressure in the tank drops to 30 psi, this switch will turn on. The pump will engage, it will pump. It will then compress the air inside of the tank to 50 psi and shut off. Now, one thing to note, there is no check valve on this line. In our area, you're required to have any check valve, or you're supposed to have a check valve before the pressure tank or any of the interior plumbing to prevent any kind of backflow or contamination into the well or surrounding water source. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna look down here at this pressure gauge. We can see here that it's reading 42 PSI. Again, this is a 30-50 switch. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn on the water and we're gonna watch as this thing drops down. As it drops, we'll see that the pressure continues to go down and down and down. And in a minute, we'll see that the pressure switch actually engages. That's where you're gonna see the interesting issue that's happening. And I want you to try and think about what might be causing that before I reveal the answer in a little bit. All right, so we see that it drops all the way down to zero, clicks back on. Now the pump's engaged. We'll go ahead, close that valve, let this thing fill back up, and we'll see where it stops. So we'll see that it keeps climbing and climbing and climbing until eventually we get to right about where we started at 42 PSI, and the pump turns off. We'll wait a few seconds, see what this does. Okay, so here's the question for you guys to think about. We have the water comes in, a 30-50 switch. It kicks on at 30 PSI, but it drops all the way to zero first. It will then pump and it will cut off at 40 PSI. Go ahead, pause now. In the comments, go ahead, write what you think might be going on. So now that you've had some time to think about it, let's talk about what's going on. So the first thing that we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna open this up, turn the power at the breaker off, drain the tank, and then go up to here and check the air pressure up top, right? So what we found while we're doing this is that when this tank is empty, there's actually 34 PSI of pre-charge inside of this tank. Generally, a new tank will have 38 PSI, as most new installs will be a 40-60 switch. So the tank was pre-charged at 34. Somebody installed a 30-50 switch. So what's happening is the pressure tank has more pressure than what the switch will engage on. So what happens when the water is going through, you'll actually have it bottom out all the way, which is why this goes to zero before you get less than 30 PSI. And now the switch engages. And then so what'll happen in the house is you'll see the water will be steady, 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 bottom pulse, steady, 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 bottom pulse. That's gonna cause some excessive wear and tear on the well pump, the equipment in the home, as well as the pressure tank. So our suggestion today is to either A, decrease the air pressure in the tank to get it to 20 PSI, or B, install a new pressure switch. Whenever you have a pressure tank pressure switch combo, as all well systems are going to, if you have a 30-50 switch, your cut-on pre-charge in the tank should always be 2 PSI less than the cut-on. So in this case, it would need to be 28 PSI. If we were to upgrade this to the correct switch that's designed for this tank when it was installed, a 40-60 switch would mean that this needs to be 38 PSI. This would work at 40-60, and that would give you a nice, smooth, even flow. Not a super big issue, but it's important to make sure that whenever you're getting your house inspected or having your well looked at, have it properly evaluated by a professional who knows what they're looking at, so that we don't end up getting something very simple to fix, costing you hundreds or thousands of dollars down the road. If you guys enjoy videos like this, please go ahead and give me a like, subscribe, and then I will have more videos posted daily on anything that we can see in this world that might be of interest to you. Let me know what you think.